this is
Reish.
Reish.
Aleph.
Aleph. And this is Dalit.
Lamed. Good job.
Got a name, everything.
How are you feeling?
I feel good.
This is a...
This is 6 months before.
I was good. Sheen.
I already know what my year looks like.
Your Hebrew's pretty good.
Strictly boxing.
Do you want to fight twice this year, three times? How many times does Danny Garcia want to be in the ring next year?
So I'm fighting in April. If I could get another one in the summertime, one at the end of the year, I could pull off three. It's just all about the timing of everything and what they got planned.
And one of them will be a rematch, hopefully, or one of the other champions?
Yeah, definitely. I want the rematch for sure. I'm going to get this victory and get a rematch for Porter Thurman.
Danny, Granados comes forward, he lets his hands go, he gave Sean Porter a tough fight, he gave Broner a tough fight. This is not an easy fight.
No, definitely not. You know, he's coming to fight. My job is to train hard and make it easy, and that's what I'm going to do that night.
Out of all the fights here today, who do you think is the biggest underdog? Which fighter versus which fighter?
I would say Mikey.
Why? Mikey versus Spencer.
Yeah, I would say Mikey versus Spencer. He had a good point. They do have the same equal amount of skills. And that, you know, Mikey can fight. You know, he has a lot of skills. But I'm a fighter who went up from 140 to 147, and he's coming up from 135 to fight, you know, probably the biggest welterweight. And, you know, just from me doing 140, 147, there is the difference in physical strength. And I was a real strong, one of the strongest 140-pound fighters. So, that's probably why I would say he's the biggest underdog.
You said this is the longest that you've known about your fight ahead of time.
Yeah.
Since this is so different than what you're accustomed to, does it make you change up your fight preparation, or how does it make it different since you have more time to consider
things? No, it just makes me lock in. You know, now I gotta eat and sleep it. So it's gonna be on my mind for 6 months. So that's the good and bad thing about it. So yeah, I'm going to be in the game.
You fought half of the stage.
Yeah.
Who would you want to fight next? If you could line up the next four fights for Danny Garcia.
Man, I really want to fight Porter and Thurman again. Like, I know I'm the better fighter than those guys. You know, the Porter fight, I felt like I won. Like, I won hands down. Like, I felt like I won the fight. The Thurman fight was a close fight, but I thought I pulled that one off. You know, I just want to get this victory and to see what comes my way. But those are two fights I really want.
No.
And I'm better than them.
Danny, what advice would you give Garcia, maybe even Canelo, as far as like a fighter moving up the weight, fighting a bigger guy, a lot bigger guy?
Yeah.
Well, you've done it before. What advice can you give those guys on kind of how to handle the weight and the bigger?
I mean, Canelo went up from 154 to 160 and beat Triple G, so I'm pretty sure he already knows what he got to do. But you know, Mikey's got to train hard, spar with bigger guys, work on a lot of physical strength, and work walking a lot of speed. And I think that'll be the key for him.
He revealed before his last fight that he just barely started doing sit-ups. Is that something you maybe recommend he maybe do a little more?
If it worked this much, stop. Don't even do it. Right, exactly. If it ain't broke,
right. Message to your fans, and where do people follow you, Danny?
April 20th, tune in. Danny Garcia's back. The Danny Garcia Show.
On Fox. Were on HBO, you were on Showtime, you're now on Fox TV.
I mean, I'm on all platforms, so just tune in, you know? God knows where you're going to see me next.
And it's at Swift. What is it, the handle?
Just search Danny Swift Garcia, and it'll pop up all platforms.
All right, there you have it. Thank you, Danny.
Yep.